Hi, I'm Charlotte Ross, and I'm here in D.C. Trying to campaign to get people to sign on for the Great Chimp Protection and Cost Savings Act. I was on the Hill all day yesterday, and it was an honor, and it was very eye-opening. I have a deep respect for people that campaign for issues they really believe in, because you really have to run around a lot, and you really have a lot of convincing to do. But it was really fun to be a part of, and I really think this bill is overdue, and it's getting a lot of momentum. I think it's going to be passing. I hope it's going to be passing soon. But and we started with a congressional hearing where we all kind of spoke on a panel, and I was with some doctors that know a lot about alternative testing to chimpanzees, because the chimpanzee testing is honestly just not working. The HIV is unfortunately not working. The hepatitis B studies is just not working. So 80 to 90% of chimpanzees are just sitting and languishing in these barren, cold, concrete cells, sometimes not seeing any sun. And so there's really 3 points to this bill. And I was just honored to be a part of it, because I've been passionate about chimpanzees for years. I'm an animal activist, but this is probably my number one cause. I've been a big fan of Jane Goodall since I was a little girl. And ever since I looked into the eyes of a chimpanzee, I've been compelled to do everything I can to try to help them. They have this intense need for social interaction. They have an obvious amount of intelligence, but their emotions are parallel and honestly run the gamut to the human experience, from excitement to nervousness to anxiousness to boredom. And it's really those similarities that are the very things that keeping them in confinement so horrific and archaic. And the Humane Society of the United States has done an amazing job and went behind the scenes of a laboratory, and they didn't, you know, magnify anything. The facts are there, and how they're treated is one of the three main issues for me, and that is simply the moral issue. The moral and ethical issue of how they treat these majestic animals is horrific, and I think most people are innately animal lovers, and I think if people really knew what happened in these laboratories, this bill would have been passed a long time ago. The second issue is the money savings. We are in such a horrific state in the United States right now of being in debt, and we really need to save money, as everybody knows, and we're cutting so many things that are quite needed, and this isn't needed, and across the board, mainly doctors agree that it's not needed. It's kind of an old standard that people are holding on to, and what it is it costs $30 million a year to keep these chimpanzees. And again, I think I said 80 to 90% aren't even being utilized. They're just sitting there, wasting away. And what this bill is trying to do is phase this out and bring them into sanctuary so they can retire and live out their days. And there was one woman on the panel yesterday who has a sanctuary, and she showed them when they would first come in, very ghost-like, missing hair from pulling it out and having gashes in their arms. Actually diagnosed from psychiatrists as having postpartum depression. And then a year later, seeing them in the sun, languishing, doing yoga, having fun. And even though some have been in confinement since they were taken from the wild, we're talking 30 years they've been in a solitary confinement, to see them be free and happy brings tears to your eyes. It's a beautiful thing. So a lot of people on the Hill yesterday were listening to the cost savings, as they should, because, again, if they were making any medical strides, there would be an argument, and that's the third point, because there were doctors and professors, and over 700 doctors have signed this petition that factually they're just not needed. It's not working. They gave it a shot. Although they are so similar to the humans, they're medically, I'm not a doctor, so I can't say it as eloquently, it's not matching. It's not a good model for what our bodies do and how it reacts. And they're kind of holding on to them, saying maybe one day we'll work on it. Well, it's not working. They're dying in laboratories, and the medical community is really what's speaking right now, and that's why it's finally getting momentum, because that's the only thing that I think some of these laboratories have been holding on to. But the facts aren't there. So morally, no-brainer. Money, no-brainer. And now, with the doctors and everything that's coming forward, it's a no-brainer. So I think this is overdue. I'm really, really hopeful that the day comes soon, as I think most people are, that these poor chimps can be retired. So I'm just honored to be a part of it. I don't have a chimpanzee as a pet. I don't believe in that. I think that chimpanzees are actually should be on the endangered list. They're working on it right now. I'm putting it on the endangered list. And unfortunately, because of the entertainment industry and a lot of people kind of think that they're cute as pets. And obviously, they're adorable. But they do grow up to be quite vicious. There was a case recently of a woman that had one, and her face was ripped off, and it's horrific and tragic. But having a chimpanzee as a pet is a selfish thing to do, because it's not the right thing to do, and it will backfire, and that chimpanzee will suffer the most, if not the owner of that chimpanzee. Well, we all think chimpanzees are adorable. Let's call a spade a spade. So is a baby tiger. You go get a baby tiger as a pet. It is not the right thing to do, and the people and the animal will pay the most. And it's going to be deemed as endangered soon, so laboratories don't want that, because then they can't hold on to these chimpanzees that are just sitting there doing nothing. But I'm against private ownership of having any type of wild animal that should be in the wild. I do want to mention one more thing, and that is we are the only developed country that still has chimpanzees in cages and laboratories. The rest of the world has deemed it as morally and ethically wrong, not helping with the medical studies. And it's only because it's an old system that we haven't eradicated it. So we're really behind the eight ball, the United States, in getting this done. So again, I hope everybody supports the Humane Society of the United States if they want to see the behind the footage, behind the scenes footage of the laboratories. They can go to their website. And I really hope that this bill passes. So.